Although undoubtedly modern, Fukuoka moves at a gentle, relaxed pace. It's still a bustling city, but has a more laid-back atmosphere, especially compared to other major cities like Tokyo or Osaka. This makes Fukuoka an ideal choice for travelers visiting Japan for the first time, or a perfect first stop in a multi-city tour around the archipelago. Hi Tipiters, we are Vince and Josh. In this video, we're sharing with you some practical tips on how to make your Fukuoka trip hassle-free, especially if it's your first time. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new travel videos. Where to stay? The area used to be divided into two separate cities with a river running in between, Hakata and Fukuoka. But in 1889, they were merged to form a bigger prefectural capital named after the latter, Fukuoka City. Fukuoka, which is now a ward, and its central station retain its name, but what used to be the separate Fukuoka City is now called Tenjin. Together, these two districts make up the city center, where most of the action happens. For locals and tourists alike, this area is unavoidable. Many key tourist spots are on the Hakata side, but most budget hotels are in Tenjin. So if you can, choose a hotel that is not too far away from either Hakata Station or Tenjin Station. As long as you're close to either, it will be very easy for you to explore the rest of the city. Best time to visit. The best time to visit is October to November, all things considered. These months enjoy pleasant and dry weather, ideal for sightseeing. October is when temperatures begin to drop to 18.8 degrees Celsius average. It's also the least popular among tourists, which makes exploring a lot less stressful. If you don't mind the cold, winter is a good option too. The temperature can plunge to 5.2 degrees Celsius average, but it also sees the lowest precipitation levels. It's the second busiest season as far as tourism is concerned, especially from January to February. How to get there? Fukuoka Airport is the primary gateway to Fukuoka City and Kyushu Island in general. It is Japan's fourth busiest airport, next only to Haneda and Narita in Tokyo and Kansai in Osaka. And it's connected to virtually every other airport in the country. Fukuoka is often included in international seat sales by low-cost carriers, so always watch out for those. How to get to the city center? The good news is, Fukuoka Airport is within the city center. Hakata Station, which is the biggest and the central train station in the city, is only around 5 minutes by subway or 15 minutes by taxi. There are also a lot of hotels in the Tenjin area. Tenjin Station is just 12 minutes away by subway. The bad news is, the domestic and international terminals are housed in two separate buildings located on either side of the runway. The fastest way to reach the city center is the subway, but only the domestic terminal has a subway station. No worries though, there is a free airport bus service that ferries passengers from the international to the domestic terminal. Besides, the easiest and cheapest way to reach the city center isn't the subway, but the bus. To catch a bus, get a ticket from a ticket machine installed at the terminal. Even if you approach the man counter, you'll be pointed to the ticket machines. Then, when you have a ticket, go to bus stop number 2. If you're going to Hakata Station, ride the city bus or Nishi Tetsu bus. This bus also stops in Tenjin. If your hotel is closer to Tenjin City Hall or Canal City Hakata, go to bus stop number 4 and take the Royal bus. Taxis are generally expensive in Japan, but if you're a group of 3 or 4, it can be a great choice too. Here are the usual rates. How to get around? Most key tourist spots in Fukuoka are accessible by subway. If you've traveled to Japan before, you'll have no problem exploring Fukuoka. It's pretty much the same. But if it's your first time in Japan, it is important to be familiar with how to use the train. One thing that has proven helpful to me again and again is Hyperdia. It's a web-based search engine that would tell you train schedules and routes instantly. Just make sure that you know the nearest train station to your destination and let Hyperdia do the rest. For more information on how to use Hyperdia and Japan's train system, read our step-by-step tutorial on our written blog, www.thepoortraveler.net. Fukuoka Passes. If you're staying within Fukuoka City only and you're taking public transportation multiple times a day, get one of the following passes. Fukuoka Tourist City Pass, which will enable you unlimited rides on buses, trains, and subways around the city, except Nishitetsu Train. It's valid for 1 day. And 1 day or 2 day subway passes, which will allow you unlimited rides on any Fukuoka City subway routes. But subway only, buses are excluded. If you think none of these passes are for you but you don't want to fall in line or get a ticket each time you use public transportation, you can use Hayaka Ken IC card instead. All you need to do is hover the card upon entry to the subway station or bus and you're good to go. But Aikoka, Suica, and Pasmo IC cards all work in Fukuoka just as well. All these passes are available at the following spots among others. Train Pass for Fukuoka and Hiroshima or Yamaguchi. If you plan on exploring multiple destinations in Hiroshima and Yamaguchi prefectures and coming in via Fukuoka, consider the JR Yamaguchi Area Pass. This will enable you to get unlimited access to designated JR trains including Shinkansen and bus lines within Hiroshima and Yamaguchi. This also covers Shinkansen rides to and from Fukuoka and ferry ride to Miyajima. If your trip is only 5 days, this is a good deal. The Shinkansen ride from Hakata Station to Hiroshima alone is already over 8,000 yen one way, but this pass costs only 11,000 and it gives you much more, and valid for 5 days. Train Pass for Fukuoka and other cities in Kyushu Island. If you plan on visiting multiple destinations on Kyushu Island aside from Fukuoka City, like Nagasaki, Oita, Beppu, Saga, and Kumamoto, it may be wise to get a JR Kyushu Rail Pass. There are three types available: the Southern Kyushu Pass, the Northern Kyushu Pass, and the All Kyushu Rail Pass. Only the last two cover Fukuoka. JR Northern Kyushu Pass, which covers the northern cities of the island including Fukuoka, is available in 3-day and 5-day versions. While the All Kyushu Rail Pass gives you unlimited access to the JR rail network within the island, north and south included, available in 3-day and 5-day varieties. Places to visit. Fukuoka is easy to explore. Here are some of the best attractions in the prefecture. For the details, watch out for our next video which tackles the best things to do in Fukuoka Prefecture. If you need more information about traveling to and around Japan, check out the comprehensive travel guides on our blog www.thepoorttraveler.net. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new travel videos. We're Vince and Josh, see you again next time. Plan smart, travel safe, and make every trip worth it.